You're listening to the AfterBuzz TV Network, now the largest new media platform on the web, and your number one source for after-show entertainment.
Very good, Johnson.
From the AfterBuzz Studios in Los Angeles, California, presented by Maria Menounos and Bing.com, and streaming live thanks to Akamai Technologies, this is AfterBuzz TV's So You Think You Can Dance After Show. We'll break down tonight's episode and get you all the latest news and gossip. If you'd like to buzz in on tonight's show, you can buzz us at 424-256-1729. That's 424-256-1729. And now, another post-game wrap-up show for your favorite TV show. It's AfterBuzz TV's So You Think You Can Dance After Show.
What's up, boys and girls? Bing is for doing. We're here doing another recap show for Love in the Wild. We are not here for Love in the Wild. We're here for So You Think You Can Dance. Wrong show, wrong night. I'm your host, AJ Gibson. I host way too many shows here at AfterBuzz. I'm so furious over what I just saw that I'm
so
discombobulated.
That's why it's all good.
You changed the name of the show.
I did. I'm mad right now.
New kind of mad.
Yes.
You and me both.
You mad too. Do you notice who we have in the studio, everyone? We have Comfort.
Whoop, whoop.
From multiple seasons. What seasons were you on again?
Season 4.
And then again?
Season 7.
Okay.
Then season 8.
Okay, she's been around
for
a while.
Get you alive.
Get it.
She's sitting in the entire night. We're going to have a little scoop from her later.
Okay.
She's going to sit in and go through these performances with us with my regular co-host.
She has a lot of
Corrine.
Shaking my head.
How you doing?
What a do, Bo.
And we got Kristyn.
I'm glad
over
you're
here.
Back.
I'm glad I'm back too. How are you, Kristyn? Did you miss me?
I did miss you. Good to see you.
You stepped up for me, though.
She was good last week.
Thank you. I tried.
You know what you're doing. You're a pro. Oh,
thank you.
So once again, So You Think You Can Dance. What's up? Episode 9, season 9. I'm mad right now.
I'm hot.
I've never experienced this yet at AfterBuzz. Going straight into the live show after watching it and being upset.
I just want to get straight down to the ending. The
I
point.
Know.
Like,
because I feel like, what's the point of so going mad? Over some of this? That's what I don't like about the new format this year.
I don't like it either.
It drives me crazy because I will just say this. We're going to get to it in just a moment. But Brandon and Amber both went home tonight. We all know that. You all just watched it.
Two Browns.
And the best performance of the night came from Brandon and Amber, so I'm just mad. I feel like, okay, I'm just going to throw this away.
And
like,
Brandon's my boy, so that...
I wish Seth, Brandon were my boy. I hear you.
I mean, you know. I get it.
Ain't mad at him.
But Dimples, man, that's my boo. Like,
I felt like they got rid of the man and the woman on the show. If that makes
wow.
sense. Like, they're
the
adults
yeah.
on the show.
They're the mature dancers.
Yeah.
And
yeah,
you
kept
really
the little
strong.
Kids.
Like, Amber, like,
she
nobody's
especially.
Got that body like that. And her strength.
And her
and she finally got her hair right this season after 14 tries.
I don't know about all that.
We love you, Amber. It's cute.
She was still on Struggle Life with the hair.
She's doing that blonde thing.
No,
it's cool.
I don't like
well,
it.
Well, she had brown. It was brownish.
It was better. It was better. I mean, because we saw some evolutions in some old tape at the end of tonight, and I was like, whoa.
You know what? She's a jack of all trades. She can, let her switch. Let her switch.
She did switch. She got plenty of time to switch up as much as she want now, and nobody going to notice because she's no longer on the show.
Ooh.
She can change her hair color every day, and nobody's going to know.
That
breaks my heart. Let's start at the top of the show. Let's get through. Let's just give time to these other performers that are coming back this week.
Well, let's talk about these guys.
I know, right? We have special guest judge Christina Applegate, which is
love
fantastic
her.
Because she's great.
She
knows.
She's actually really good.
Yeah, she knows her stuff.
She watches the show, and I think that's the bottom line. When someone doesn't watch a show, a la Zooey Deschanel, who's like, good teamwork, guys. I'm
these
like,
guys
she's
are
trying
wonderful.
To be nice. She likes to try to be nice and stuff.
Right. I also say Christina Applegate, she has a history as a dancer. I know that back when I was a kid, my cousin used to, I grew up in Ohio, and she would win these dance competitions all the time. And each summer, she would get a scholarship to come out to California and dance at, what was the studio? I think I said it to you. It was in North Hollywood. It was
Millennium?
Tremaine. Joe Tremaine. Yeah, over in North Hollywood, which ended up years later when my sister and I moved to North Hollywood. We lived across the street from it. We faced it. And it's the studio we'd heard about all these years where my cousin had actually danced, and Christina Applegate danced with her back in the day there.
Aww.
So she actually has a dance history. So she knows what she's doing. She knows what she's talking about.
She's a Broadway.
She did Broadway, right?
Sweet Charity.
She said that she did that show for a year.
She did say that. She did say that.
Yeah.
She was a dancer who sang, not a
singer
who danced.
She said like 2 hours, like on stage, just full out, nonstop.
I could do that.
You could.
No, I couldn't.
No?
I'm not a dancer. So, first performance of the night. Yes, you could. No, first performance of the night. We've got George and Tiffany.
Yes.
Okay? What do we think about this? The Nappy Tabs number. They did Nappy Tabs. I think they choreographed 32
routines tonight. All the dancers tonight.
They're trying to
They are the hip-hop choreographers of the season.
I feel like contractually they're trying to get in all the choreography before she pops that baby.
Yeah. She's going on maternity leave. Yeah. They're like, you're contracted for this many, and you're going to have contractions soon, so we're going to take you out.
Ooh, nice play on words. Oh, Kristyn Burtt. Witty. Yeah, impressive.
Ooh, hand clap.
Clap it up.
So George and Tiffany. This is what I wrote down.
Tell us.
They had cute costumes, and they had cute props, which they didn't use at all. It reminded me, what did I say? It reminded me that Maya song, Rugrats.
Rugrats are.
I like that.
Yes. Except for they weren't. Yeah. We had a singer in the house.
She's a
Comfort.
Singer and a dancer.
Triple threat. Watch out.
Entertainer. Watch out. Get your life.
Get it. Found it.
Oh, catch it. Grab it.
But I don't feel like they used the choreography very well. I feel like it was almost, it was fun and playful, but kind of childish.
It was a fun opening, but, there were all these props, and you're kind of waiting for them to, like, use the crib or use the dresser, and then nothing happened.
Is this more of a character dance? Like, it didn't have as much hip-hop as I would love to have seen it, since it's a hip-hop routine.
Right, and I feel like Nappy Taps can kind of go that direction sometimes.
Yeah, they get into character. It's just more of a character dance. Let's call it maybe that rather than anything else. But, I mean, it was colorful. It was cute.
Yeah, that's what I put.
Speaking of colorful, I love your top. What did you think of this number?
Well, I just said flatline, And then I just wrote down what Nigel said. His critique to them was he wants the hip-hop routine to be, like, grungier. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And I was like, yeah, I get it.
It didn't have
hip-hop. Yeah. It was just poppy to me, like a cheer routine, you know?
It felt like... like a Disney number or like a Justin Bieber, Selena Gomez type of number or something.
I feel like we went to the El Capitan, which is a Disney theater in Hollywood. Yeah. Yep. So I went down there and I went and saw a show. I paid $15 to see that. That's what I feel like I did. Yeah. In one show, animated movie.
Ooh, that's not good when it's supposed to be hip hop. That's not good.
No, it's not.
That's not good.
It's theme park choreography.
Well, let's X that out then.
I don't know. I didn't dislike it. I didn't dislike it. It didn't change my life.
Right.
I'll say that.
You didn't get your life.
No, it didn't get my life at all.
He didn't get his life.
I like seeing groove.
This next number, though, I feel like it's a moot point to even talk about now.
What is the point?
Brandon and Amber. They did their choreographer was Ray Leeper. I'm not familiar.
Is he new?
Apparently.
I want to think he's new on the show.
I don't know anything about him.
I didn't either, and they didn't really describe who he was.
I wish they would have.
I wish they would have, too, because it was fantastic. We'll have to do a little Googling on him.
This number I wrote down, so 1, 2, 3, 4 O's, sexy. I would have written down more, but I was running out of ink.
It was so beautiful. Like, that soul, that grimy, the blackness together. Mm-hmm. They was just feeling it.
That's right. Ground love.
They were feeling it. They were feeling it.
I said it reminded me, this is terrible, the movie Color Purple, the scene where Sugar comes and she's singing in the shack and they're all like,
the Color Purple.
And they're all like dancing and grooving and getting like down, just sweaty, nasty in the middle of the summer. Like, it felt like that sort of number.
So the Color
They were
Purple.
Styled that way. It was very, very sexual. They were all over each other. You know the scene I'm talking about.
I know, but that is no relation. This dance.
She's talking about the blackness of this. I mean, what is more black than the color purple?
To the color purple. These are one generation. Shug.
She can't. Well, there ain't nothing black than the color purple. I see
said
that part,
it was amazing, and it was not a color purple number. It was sexy. It was
Porgy and Bess. Porgy and Bess would be sexier. No.
Fair enough.
I think so.
Fair enough. I just thought there was something about this number.
You mean something about Brandon?
Oh,
yeah.
Brandon.
Dimples.
Call me.
No, not dimples. Chest for days.
Yo, you see the sweat? It was just drizzling. Yeah. It was drizzling. And it had a pulse, too.
The screenshot afterwards when they were getting interviewed by Kat Dealey, the mic was not at their mouths. It was right in the middle of his abs the entire time. And he was just like dripping, and she's kept the mic there for a solid 2 minutes.
She wanted to do this.
Yeah.
But let's talk about it, because all of us were making like sexual innuendos the entire time. The entire room was admitted, everyone. Mm-hmm. Yeah, everyone's looking really guilty.
I am.
I think that there's a possibility Amber could be pregnant right now. I'm not sure after that.
If
I don't know.
She isn't, I am.
I might be.
Leapt through the screen.
Yeah. I thought. I
this was Amber's night. I mean, honestly.
This was Amber's night.
It was Amber's night. Brandon looked great, and, you know, he was a fantastic partner and everything, and I know we think he's really hot and sexy, but this was the Amber show, and this was such a wonderful showcase piece for her, and it's why I'm really upset, because I felt she got hosed, not only with some mediocre choreography the last couple weeks, but also with a partner that could not match up to her level of dance. You know, Nick, I thought it was appropriate that he went home last week.
Yeah, it breaks my heart because I feel like she did get a raw deal, especially after I make jokes that she's tried out 112 seasons, but I think she's tried out 4 or 5 seasons now. Yeah. And to finally get on the show, she's a committed dancer. Yes. She's here because she wants to be. And I say, I've talked about this with everyone here a few times. I think that early in the season, there's a lot of duplicate dancers. There's a few of the blonde girls that are all the same. A few brunette girls are all kind of the same. You know, a few contemporary dancers. I feel like there's nobody else that's like Amber. She's it. And she's powerful. And she's stunning to look at.
Sorry. Yeah. And she's the only brown girl. Mm-hmm. Big ups to the brown sister. Mm-hmm. And everybody else, to me personally, they all look alike.
Yeah.
Like Ileana and Janelle. And then Lindsay and Whitney. Like, they all look alike.
The duplicates. I think the Amber and I think the Amelia. Mm-hmm. They're interesting. They look different.
Yep.
And it didn't, I thought it would help Amber, and it really didn't.
Besides that, she has extensions. Like, she's... She was all around as a beautiful dancer, just as well as all the other, you know, duplicates of everyone else. And she held it down completely.
And I think that more than any girl this entire night, not only was her, I thought her technique was stunning. Phenomenal, she connected to this number like no one even came close to the entire night.
She understood it. She understood where it was coming from and then where it was going. Mm-hmm. So she took you on that journey, which is really important.
And I think, to his credit, you know, he's a stepper, but Brandon was right there with her.
He was great.
I think he held his own just fine. And he partnered her very well. Yep. He was strong when he needed to be, and he was
a man.
Yeah.
Oh.
And you guys, just on Ray Leeper, I did look it up. Season 8, he was a choreographer in season 8. So we have seen him before.
Well, welcome back, Ray.
There you go.
Way to go. Give us the best choreography of the night. We're never going to see it again.
And now you're gone.
I can't. I love that Nigel made a comment, and this is exactly what I think all of us were thinking. I actually said this a minute ago. He called it baby-making choreography. Baby-making choreography. I'm like, okay.
Yes.
Absolutely. I don't disagree, because all of us were thinking it.
And Mary said that it's the soul in the train.
Yeah. She said the soul.
She was like, y'all know Soul Train? I liked it. I'm sad that they're gone.
I'm sad too.
I am too. I'm going to come back to it. We're just going to talk about Amber and Brandon over and over again.
We can't get over it.
I will find a way to bring Brandon up every episode for the rest of the season, just so you guys are clear.
Thank you.
Moving on. We've got Pasha coming back to choreograph a number for Darian.
Darian and Janelle.
Darian and Janelle.
I love Pasha.
Yeah, I do too.
Such a humble heart. Love you.
Now, what season did he come from?
He came from season 3.
So did you ever get to work with him on any of your other seasons? Or was he a choreographer?
He was an all-star. He was an all-star on season 7.
So
I got to work with him within that. But other than that, we just kind of hang or see him every once in a while.
He seems like a really nice guy.
He's actually a humble, humble spirit. Like, when you talk to him, sometimes you don't know what he's saying because he's too smooth. You're like...
And Russian. Let's just clarify.
And Russian. Love that. Yeah. And you're just like, you just want to just look at him. You're like, yeah, whatever you said, true.
You're with it.
True. He's a strong choreographer.
Yes.
I think he brings like that young, that flavor, like young, like to these numbers. Yeah, that could be a little bit kind of, you know, boring for people who aren't big fans of like ballroom styles. But he brings an edge to it, which I like. He choreographed this number for Darian and Janelle, and I said that they had great lifts. I really enjoyed the lifts. Had a really sexy ending. Uh-huh. I loved the ending.
Mm-hmm.
However, much of the dance, like the, I say links, I think is what it is. They didn't link it felt like this, then this, then this, and it didn't flow.
They were grabbing for hands a lot. We were talking about it, but they were kept on missing their hands, so they were grabbing arms and wrists, anything, because they needed to have that connection for the next turn or the next lift or whatever was happening.
So those moments were awkward.
Very sloppy. It was really sloppy.
See, and I didn't notice. Like, I'm not a trained or technical dancer. I'm just a fan of the show. Right. But you know some words. But I'm just a fan of the show, so when you guys were commenting on that, I was like, well, what? It looked good to me.
Yeah.
You know, and I'm, you know, Nigel said that, you know, he didn't feel that she was sexy. I was like, I did. Like, she was hot in her little glitter dress.
See, now I wrote down they lacked connection in sex.
It's funny. No chemistry.
I didn't see it.
What makes it like, what do you guys see that I'm not seeing?
Well, I think because, I mean, I've been there before. So when you get so wrapped up in, like, the misconnections, when you're kind of, like, thinking about the steps only, you're kind of out. You're not there anymore after a while, because you're too busy thinking about this next move and these big tricks and all this stuff. So there was not a night. It was just a little bit of a moment.
And you can see in a dancer's eyes when they're just thinking, get through the choreography and get to where I need to go and put my hand where it needs to be and catch this person when I need to catch them. You can see it in their eyes.
You can see them counting sometimes, or you can see them just like kind of panicking, like we're a little bit behind or a little bit ahead. And think of what you saw with Amber, how amazing and how connected you felt to that. Mm-hmm. We didn't feel that same thing with Janelle and Darian.
I didn't dislike it. I actually don't think I hated any performance tonight.
Nope.
There were a lot of okay ones. There were a couple of standouts, a lot of okay ones for me. Mm-hmm. I didn't really, like, a couple weeks ago, the number in the all red with the tights, and then I hated that.
Like Alexa.
Alexa, so.
You guys, we have a phone call. Hey, who do we have on the line? This is AJ. Who do we have?
Yeah, my name is Mackenzie.
What's up? How you doing?
Hey.
You a fan of the show?
Hi. Yeah, man. I started watching the show actually at the Challenge Island. So since then, I've been like picking up on those episodes, and I started watching the Real World here in Vegas, and then maybe this one.
So, did you watch tonight's episode? What do you think of tonight's episode?
Yeah, I think it was better than the last episode, but I think that this season is still slow.
Uh-huh.
And I can't wait for the drama to start.
For the drama?
Yeah. Oh, you waiting for drama.
I thought tonight was drama.
You waiting for some hair swinging.
I thought the elimination tonight was pretty dramatic. I wasn't really a fan of that.
Yeah, but, you know, I'm talking about the real drama, you know?
The real drama, huh?
Well,
you know what? Yeah. You need to keep tuning in. Maybe next week we'll have a little more drama. You hope so?
Yeah, I hope so.
Well, thank you so much for calling in and for being a fan.
Thank you.
Keep tuning in, all right? Take care, buddy.
All
right. Bye, thank you.
Does he know what show he just called in for?
No, I don't think he did, but that's what
he thought he was calling into the Real World.
I do, too. I was like, what did you say? Wrong show.
He likes Las Vegas, and I don't.
He sounds, he sounds like a big fan of the arts.
This is why we love it live. You know, the one thing I do want to say about this dance is that I think the song was pretty uninspired. We've heard Carly Rae Jepsen all summer long, and it's really hard to get excited about that.
That was that number, wasn't it?
Yeah,
I didn't write that
maybe.
Down.
Yeah.
I love that song. You know, is that why I liked it? Because I liked the song?
Maybe.
It's cute and boppy, but at the same time, to dance to it. Yeah, Carly Rae Jepsen, that song is hard. If you're doing, if you're doing ballroom.
Yeah.
Yeah, that is a
tricky
one.
I didn't like it for ballroom, but I like the song.
I think the song itself is pretty childish, and it made the choreography look a little childish, as opposed to, and that maybe that's why there was no sex. How can you put sex and, like, really have some chemistry in a song about this summer pop song about Kami, maybe? Like, really?
I think Justin Bieber.
Yeah.
In his little video with and Ashley Tisdale was in it. You know, they did their own little, made their own music video to that.
They made one,
so
too.
So did Katy Perry.
I didn't know Ashley Tisdale was still around. But hey, guys, we want to take a moment to thank you guys for watching, to let you know that if you guys want to help us out and keep us doing what we're doing, keep the lights turned on here in the studio, keep Corrine having a good time, because she looks like she's having a good time tonight.
You're cracking me up.
If you guys have any purchases to make on Amazon, we really appreciate it if you do it through AfterBuzz TV. You can log on to our website, AfterBuzzTV.com, and there's a large banner at the top of the screen for Amazon. By making the one extra click and making your purchases through our website, we get a little kickback. It keeps us doing what we do and providing free content for you guys, which we love to do, and it allows us to bring guests like Comfort in, and we've got more guests coming up for the rest of the season, so I'll be really excited about that. But if you guys can make your purchases, it doesn't cost you an extra penny, but it really helps us out. I told my last show this, I'm going to tell you again, I bought a green screen setup for my apartment through AfterBuzz TV on Amazon.com the other day. It came in today, so I'm going to do a green screen, and I got the proper lighting and everything, so I'm going to start making a little makeshift studio in my house.
That's so nice.
Yeah. We'll be over soon.
Pretty That's excited nice. About it. We can all shoot and play around. Yay. We can play host at my house now. So if you guys would make your purchases for on Amazon through AfterBuzz, we really appreciate it, you guys. Thank you so much.
That's nice. Okay.
Our next duo, we've got Cole and Lindsay.
Oh, Cole.
Oh, the Mandy Moore routine.
The Mandy Moore routine.
Mandy Moore.
I'm a fan of Mandy Moore.
I like her.
I am a fan of Mandy
Good Moore. Choreographer.
Mm-hmm. Yes, and she was also great in A Walk to Remember. Oh, wait, that's a different
right.
one.
Yeah.
I got jokes.
I was not
going to do jokes.
So, Cole. Cole is phenomenal.
Committed.
Yes. He immerses himself in each routine in a way that I don't know that I've ever really seen on the show.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
He's intense.
He's connected, like you said.
He's all in. Mm-hmm. He's all in and then some. And, you know, I think the one really interesting note that Nigel made about this dance, too, and about Cole specifically, that he is a technician. And oftentimes technicians lose the performance value because they're just, their technique is phenomenal and they become like machines. Mm-hmm. But he has both sides to it, which is unusual in a dancer. You're usually a performer or you're a technician.
Well, Nigel did warn, though, that it could get boring at some point. He needs to find that extra gear, find the, in, the thing inside of him that really helps him connect. Luckily for him, I think that... the choreography was stunning. Obviously, I think Mandy Moore's genius. And the lighting. The lighting was beautiful.
It's like it made it.
Mm-hmm.
It made that routine.
What was it? I always say it creates like frames.
Snapshot.
Like, snapshots. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Snapping.
So cool. So cool.
And they got nominated for an Emmy for lighting design. So that's a great example of why they're nominated this year.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It really is.
I said Cole's my new found favorite. Because last week I was like, oh, okay, great. He stayed in character and did a dance really well. Mm-hmm. But this week I was like, wow.
Yeah, he's interesting.
I really like him.
He's kind of growing on me.
Yeah, I'm drawn to him now. And I was like, oh, Lindsay, who? Like, I was just concentrated on him. Like, he was, Nigel said, he was like meticulous and neat, you know, in his dancing. And I was like, wow.
I think still to me, I my eye is on him. Like, I don't know why. He's so captivating. He brings you into what he's doing. Like, he is so committed and he's so drawn into his character and into his partner that no one else is around. So you can just feel.
I love that you said that because that's exactly what I was feeling. Mm-hmm. For whatever reason, and it's that X factor. I don't know what it is about him, but I can't stop staring at him when he's dancing.
He's
just phenomenal. And it's not that he's the best dancer or the best performer or the best anything. He's just interesting.
Charisma.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You can't manufacture it. You just have it or you don't, and he's got it.
True story.
I think he's going to do really well.
Yeah, Nigel called him a genius.
Yeah.
I'm excited to see what he'll do next.
Me too. And our next number actually was also choreographed by Mandy Moore. Did I write that down wrong?
No, you're right.
Back to back?
It was the jazz routine.
It was back to back.
All right, so we got Will and Amelia. They're a really interesting couple. A duo. I like them together because she's weird to me, but likable at the same time. And he's like big and kind of not in the best shape and kind of just whatever.
He's like goofy and cute.
Yeah, I called him the Vince Vaughn of the show. He's like that guy. He's that guy that girls fall for that's not necessarily the best looking guy or in the best shape or whatever, but he's kind of weird and quirky. But his sense of humor makes him so attractive.
Yeah.
And he can dance.
He's cuddly.
Yeah.
He has a good spirit, it seems like.
Yeah.
He has pretty good spirit.
It reads well.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You just want to, I feel like I'd want to be friends with him. And those are the type of people you vote for, though.
Agree.
I always mention season one. Don't forget, Benji won season one. He wasn't the best dancer, but I loved Benji.
Everybody
such a nice guy.
Him.
Like, I was like, oh, I love this kid.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. He ran away with the show. Will can be a little dark horse. He's a surprise to people.
I think so. He's looking a little bit more in shape, I thought.
Well, you have to be
as
much as he's a little less doughy.
Yeah, he was a little doughy early on.
He was. He showed it, though. He was like, oh, my God.
He was doughy.
What did you guys think about the costumes?
I hated them.
Did you?
Oh, was that the black? It was black and white.
The black and white. And Nigel called it very black and white. The routine.
Yeah.
It's tough to carry a white on male or female, but I mean he had on tight white pants. They were disco.
And they had stirrups. Did we notice that? Stirrups.
No, I didn't notice.
They connected under his feet. Did you see that?
No, did Amelia's too?
I don't know if hers did, but his connected under his feet.
Oh.
Yeah, I said that I think Amelia her costume made sense on her. Because she's weird like that, and I enjoyed it on her. His was a little different, and the white is a little harder to pull off.
Yeah.
I mentioned, what was the Mark.
Mark.
He danced for Lady Gaga now. He was on season...
I love Mark.
Four.
Yeah. It was on your
and
season.
Seven.
Okay,
and seven.
Okay, so
yeah,
you danced...
Awesome. Yeah,
mm-hmm. I feel like he could have danced the hell out of that number, and he could have rocked that
in
white.
In that white suit, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
For sure.
Yeah,
for
I'm
sure.
with it.
But I was proud of Will. I wasn't mad at him.
They're cute. They're quirky. And, you know, even if this wasn't their best week, it certainly wasn't a horrible dance. You know what I mean?
No.
They still have that fun, playful, you know, chemistry together. And I think they're going to go really far.
Yeah. Just a quick sidebar. Can I mention how much I love your mom? She is so adorable.
She is. She's just over there laughing.
She giggles up a storm. She's so excited. She's crying. That's how she thinks I'm funny is what it is.
Yeah.
Or I'm funny looking. I don't know. She's laughing at these bangs.
She's having blast. How you doing over there, mama?
She's okay. I love your mom.
She's Brie, need some water? You good?
Let's just say she looks like your sister, too.
Oh, I know, mom. Right? So. When you said mom, I was like,
Got some good genes.
She's a smart lady, you. Too. She's a smart she lady. Is. She thinks I'm funny. I like that.
Oh,
I like
that. She's smart.
Moving on, we've got a Liz Lyra number. And the dancers are Matt and Audrey.
Some salsa.
Yeah. What do we think about the salsa number?
Ryan Gosling.
They were in all that red. Was... That's right.
Mm-hmm. Cheerios.
Very authentic. We were saying it was, I feel like it was more of an authentic, real salsa that. Dance. Mm-hmm. I don't know.
I love that you mentioned the Cheerios.
Yeah. He looked like a Cheerio with his zip, his track jacket.
Wait, but this wasn't the number. Okay, who was it that before all these dances, these dancers had to say something, a couple things about the other dancer that we didn't know about. Who was it? One of them pours orange juice on their
Keon.
Cereal.
That's
Keon.
That's Keon.
Keenan. Oh, you still don't know his name. I prematurely jumped to that because you said Cheerios.
Well, loop it back.
Maybe she's looking at my cardigan. It looks like a box
little
of Cheerios.
Honey, little honey nut.
Little honey nut.
Okay.
All right. A little bit of sweetness.
So Matt and Audrey. Okay. I loved their lifts. I thought they had fantastic lifts. Oof. Again, they created some beautiful snapshots, frames, whatever. And I liked the style of this dance, mm-hmm. of the salsa. I thought that the music was a little weird. They commented on the music later. I thought the music was nice to listen to, but it wasn't great for an exciting performance. Mm-hmm. I felt like I kind of went in and out of it a little bit, if that makes sense. Kristyn, explain what I'm trying to say right now, because I don't know.
Well, I think in the choreography, I really noticed that when they were together, it was pretty exciting, but when they put the moves apart, they kind of lost that electricity. So it felt like two separate dances going on right here when you wanted them to be one, I think. And mm-hmm. I think that's what the choreography was missing, and they felt a little lost, too. I think so. Mm-hmm. It just doesn't translate well.
I thought that he impressed me though. He surprised me. He had a little booty and he got a little twist in it.
Yeah,
and
a little twist.
He was going. Salsa's a. I mean, that's.
Salsa is an authentic kind of. Mm-hmm. You have to get really grimy. You have to. Mm-hmm. You have to really, really feel it.
You said real salsa, little mama, and I was like, I wrote that down because it made me laugh so hard. You're like, here it comes.
Here comes that real salsa.
Real salsa, spicy salsa. And not that medium or mild. It's a hot, spicy salsa. Yeah.
The one thing I noticed with Audrey, she was dancing with her shoulders up by her ears, and no one called it out on the judges' table. So I was a little bit like, I can't believe that, because you would see her like mm-hmm. just moving around like this. And in ballroom, it's so important with the proper posture. Mm-hmm. But you know, that last lift, I thought that was like great.
Over the back down into the splits under.
Yeah, that was beautiful. Then she came back up. Mm-hmm. That was hot.
But he pulled her up with all his might too.
Yes.
He was tired.
Get up here. But you have to hit that musical cue. That's it. It's like hitting that musical cue is so important, you know.
It is. But I was going to comment when you said the ballroom and her shoulders being up. I wonder if there's sometimes to me a difference between the ballroom and then like real salsa in a sense, because salsa it's such a street dance, mm-hmm. and then like ballroom it is technician. Mm-hmm. So like I think she was really going for that. So
performance
and what salsa. So you know, if they was able to bring it out a little bit more. The right, you know, dancers, maybe. Mm-hmm. It could have happened.
But they didn't
maybe?
Call her out on it, and I think that...
They didn't call her out on a lot of things.
Well, they didn't call out a lot of dancers on a lot of things tonight. Didn't. I feel like they give certain dancers passes a lot.
Yes, they do.
Did you ever feel that when you were on the show? Did you feel like certain dancers were favorites and that people were kind of treated differently or judged differently on camera?
Sometimes.
Yeah?
Yeah. Actually, all the time. Maybe. Yeah. A little bit. Yeah.
In your favor or not in your favor? I remember watching.
Now that I think about it.
I remember watching your season, your original season, mm-hmm. and I thought it seemed like you were one of the favorites, but maybe that was because you were one of my favorites. No. I don't know.
Well, I was off and on as a favorite because again, like I wasn't shown all the time in Vegas. A lot of people kind of had stories, and so when you follow their stories, then you kind of become the favorite. Until then, when you get on the show, you're like the comeback. You're like you have to kind of like prove yourself.
You're the underdog.
You got to keep continuing to prove every single week. So I was at the bottom almost every single week trying to prove myself that I'm good, and then my partners would always get kicked off, and you know, so it sometimes, you know, they do that. Other times you just never know, like they have a different format this year, so it's so different, so I don't even know.
And I think also like we all get frustrated because we all have our favorites, and that, and it kind of changes each week for me, I know.
Yeah.
But at the end of the day, they are trying to create a show, and it has to have a storyline, it has to have an arc, and there has to be drama, and I mean, maybe something like getting rid of Amber and Brandon. Maybe that's
that wasn't good drama. No, that was too early. Horrible.
I'm trying.
Don't bring it. You brought it back, and now we got a recap. No.
But one thing I want to mention about Comfort season, your original season, season four, what I was a fan. Like, that was probably my favorite season. I know, right? Hey, how? I know you guys would always do that. But what I noticed was you always would get like ballroom or like salsa. And I'm like, she is a hip hopper. And then they would always ride you so hard. And it made me so mad all the time. But they always set Chelsea up.
Well, I think it's really interesting that you bring that up, though, because this year it's different, correct, Kristyn? This year they get to pick, kind of.
Yes.
Explain that real quick, because I don't understand this exactly.
We talked about this last week when we had Ashley Galvan here, too, because she was saying the same thing. We didn't get to choose, and this time they're basically picking out of a hat what type of style they get. So, or they put it up on a board, I guess, and
so they can see
what's remaining. So you get to decide, like you and your partner go, okay, we're going to pick contemporary. So you take contemporary, and there may only be one more contemporary dance left, depending on what the choreographers are this week.
Shut up.
And so, you know, that's why last week we saw a lot of weird things going on. We saw the jive last week with Cyrus.
And Ileana.
Yeah, and which was a little unusual, but he said, oh, I let her pick. And she just picked, she was like, well, it was that or salsa. You know, she didn't really know what to pick either. So, you know, when you're at the bottom there, you're going to get whatever's left, but.
So who dictates who's the bottom?
I think they're picking out of a hat, like.
Maybe one, two, three.
You're picking first, you're picking second, you're picking third, that kind of thing. And then if you get the last pick, you're going to get what you get.
Oh, well, that's. I wish.
I don't know how I feel about the format of the show anymore. I feel like it's delving into some weird sort of.
They're trying to change it up because the ratings have gone down significantly since, you know, season four. Exactly. And, you know, you look at the prior seasons and they're just struggling. Yes. They were down to one night a week and they're just trying. They're like, what sticks? We're going to throw it up against the wall and see what sticks.
And we have less nights and more winners.
Yeah. And I don't feel. I just don't feel like it's America's show anymore, though. Like, we're really not voting because the judges already know who they're going to send home.
I do have a hard time with that. They're like, Nigel's like, we've known since last week. I'm like,
yeah. You shouldn't have vocalized that, Nigel.
Oh, you shouldn't have said that. You set yourself up.
Yeah. Because then you watch it, and even as the show starts, I'm like, I feel like I'm just getting, like, ripped off. I'm like, I'm watching all these performances. I'm going to get attached to one of them, and they're going to go home without me having any say whatsoever. Yeah. What's the incentive for me to vote? Because at the end of this show, when we just finished watching right now, I wanted to call and vote for Amber and Brandon.
Me too. Oh, yeah. And like, why? We can't.
Can't.
Yeah, that is kind of weird because they already advertised their number, and you can't vote.
Yeah. They already said, like.
It's a moot point. Oh.
Yes.
And we're going to sit on you know, we're going to sit on our voting for 3 weeks because they're out for 2 weeks because of the Olympics. So
exactly.
What's that?
Right. I don't like it. I don't know.
You know what you're going to do for the next 2 weeks? Watch Alice and Felix run. I love her. I know you're a big fan, too.
Oh, I am a huge fan of Alice. Oh, my. I
do love her, too. And Colin Jones. Check him out in the pool.
Oh, snap. I met women on them both.
I should have brought my photo with Colin.
You have a photo with Colin?
Colin Jones and me.
I'm track and field.
I'm a fan. I'm a big swimming fan. Oh, well, so we've got a couple of weeks off. We can recap. These dances better be phenomenal when we come back.
Oh, it better be two dances.
Every single one of them better be great.
it better be great.
Right. I want to know what our viewers at home think and our listeners at home think because we're all pretty upset about this Brandon and Amber thing right now. I want to see what you guys think. So get on iTunes, please, and rate and comment. Let us know what you guys think. Let us know if you like the new format. If you don't like the new format, the only way it's ever going to change is by things like this, by you guys going on iTunes and letting them know that you don't like it. I personally am not a big fan of the new format, and I'm really not a fan of Brandon and Amber going home.
Me neither.
So let us know, and we will comment back to you. We appreciate it. It's your comments and you telling your friends to get on iTunes and things like that that keep us doing what we do, and it helps us to improve each week. And let us know if you love having Comfort in the studio. If you don't, we won't ask her back. I'm just saying. We have that power. Oh. We love her. She's coming back. Don't worry. No, but let us know who else you guys want to see on the show, and we'll do our best. I know Kristyn.
I've been making phone calls and texting. I'm bugging everyone, so don't worry.
She's working hard. So we have some great guests coming up this summer. Yeah, so get on iTunes and do your part for us, and we'll do our part for you. That's how the system works.
So
we love
nice.
You guys. Yeah,
teamwork.
Did a good job.
Thank you.
That was nice.
I do what I can. Okay, Let's move on. So now we're on to Keon and Whitney. Keon, who likes to put orange juice on his Cheerios.
Hooray!
There it is. I was so excited to talk about it. Finally. I messed that up. Yeah, they did a Stacey Tukey number, mm-hmm. And they did a number to Whitney Houston's I Will Always Love You.
That carried it, man. That was beautiful. It
I'm going to let you guys talk first because I can't. I can't.
He's emotional. Comfort. Right
what
now.
Did you? No, I'm not emotional. I don't want to. I don't want to.
All right, you don't want to.
I don't want to color the commentary yet.
Exactly. That's why I love having you here. I'm like thinking in my head. I'm like, what would it be like if you threw dirt and water? That's what I'm thinking in my head. But you said you're still genius.
Don't do it.
So Comfort, what did you think of this number? Be honest.
Okay. What did I think of this number? Hmm. Well, you know what? The song itself. It's beautiful. So therefore, there's you get carried through the entire routine because of the song itself. So I don't know if I was as like emotionally attached and like I wanted to stand up and clap or whatever. Mm-hmm. I'm not sure. I don't really know how to even explain how I felt. I think I was more into the fact of Whitney Houston and the song and they moved beautifully. Mm-hmm. I mean, the choreography was great. I love Stacey. I love Stacey Tukey. She's amazing. But I'm not sure if I was that moved and taken there.
How about you, Kristyn?
I think all I needed was the a cappella section, honestly, because that is so beautiful. Whitney Houston was an incredible singer, and the choreography of that section was probably the best of it. Mm-hmm. And so I think had we just had that, maybe, we wouldn't have gone into the big, dramatic, you know. Mm-hmm. And then you start thinking, oh, Whitney Houston passed this year. Mm-hmm. We just saw an ad for Sparkle. You know what I mean? I feel like we're a little bit manipulated as an audience with the choreography and with the music and things like that. But that opening section and that one wonderful lift was unbelievable. It was spot on. It was right there with the music. She caught a lot of air, which is good. She was up there. So there were some wonderful moments about it, but is it something that made me weep? And maybe it was one of those things you had to be in studio to watch live.
Corrine?
I love the number. And probably much to what Comfort was saying, just because of the song, it helped to carry it. Mm-hmm. But taking the song out, I love Keon. He's hot to trot. And Whitney is... She's a whole ball of talent. Like, she dances her face off, and I just can watch her, like, nonstop because I just think that she's great.
Are you guys ready?
Yeah.
Okay, here goes. So, I think it's really cute that Whitney was named after Whitney Houston, and she got to dance this number. Fantastic. Yeah. Wow. Yeah. Okay. I feel like kind of like you said, I feel like we're a little bit tricked with the number. I feel like, shame on you, Stacey Tukey. I feel like... This is the oldest trick in the book. You're going to tug on some heartstrings. It's Whitney Houston. We all obviously love her. I cry listening to that song alone in my apartment. I don't care if anybody's dancing. I could be sitting in darkness listening to that song, and I will cry. Yeah. It's literally one of the most beautifully sung like songs of all time and will always be so. There's never going to be another Whitney. What's interesting is until you said Keon's name and Whitney's name, nobody mentioned Keon and Whitney. They all mentioned Whitney Houston. Everybody talked about Whitney Houston. I felt like that's what that number was about.
That's exactly
which
what
I think did a disservice to Keon and Whitney because they are both beautiful dancers.
Brilliant dancers.
I think that I understand Stacey. I get it. She was probably, I'm just dying for this next season. I can't wait to get my hands on some, you know, phenomenal dancers and do a Whitney Houston number. I get that. But it just felt a little contrived, and it felt a little sneaky, and I was like, yeah. And I saw glitter ads during dirt and glitter. Sparkle. Oh my God.
Oh Mariah, God. Wait, Whitney, Mariah. Here we go.
I just had a moment right there. No,
we just had a diva fight.
Yeah, because those are completely different titles. Sparkle, glitter, seriously. But no, Sparkle ads. And the commercials, and I'm just like, Whitney. And then I'm just hearing about Bobby Christina the last couple of days. She's been in the news, so I'm just like, it seems weird, odd timing. I understand that she had great intentions. She was trying to pay tribute to Whitney, which I respect, but I've seen enough of those. I love her. I just want to see the dancing. I just want to see. And the dancing was good.
Yeah.
It was phenomenal. I don't know that I would have had such a reaction to it. I think I almost, even if the number was phenomenal, I didn't have a reaction to it because I shut myself down immediately as soon as I knew they were dancing to Whitney. Mm. I didn't even give them a chance anymore.
Wow.
So I was like, nope, I'm not going to get tricked.
Oh, wow.
So I kind of held back a little bit, I think.
And Keon did some of his best partnering because he's been struggling in the partnering, and he was really strong this week, too. Mm. So
yeah. I feel like this number, had they danced it to, I said, Mary Had a Little Lamb, and then I still had an emotional reaction, then you know it's good choreography. Anything, I could go out and do, Corrine and I could go out and do a number of My Heart Will Go On, or I'll Always Love You, or any one of Whitney's phenomenal songs. I Want to Dance with Somebody, whatever. And it'd be great.
You just threw Celine in there too. I love it. It's like Throwdown of the Divas.
I know, I did it. You see how you're covered from that quickly though? I said My Heart Will Go On, like, that's not Whitney. Next, I Will Always Love You. Recover.
And I cannot wait for a Titanic number.
For those of you just tuning in, this is not Love in the Wild. This is So You Think You Can Dance, season 9.
He's I'm on all, every show.
I'm all over the
every
place.
Every show here.
I'm a little sleepy. I take a 5-hour energy next week before I come in here, get my brain working. So moving on from Whitney and Celine.
May she rest
Mariah.
In peace.
And Mariah. Yes. I am.
Everybody.
I'm a mess.
Yes, you
that
are.
New mess. It was good.
Sparkle,
though.
Glitter. I mean,
seriously. Sparkle's going to be way better than glitter.
Nappy tab. Choreograph the next number. Shocking. Cyrus Eliana. Another nappy tabs number.
They're again. Laboring before labor.
Yes. Yes.
Oh, nice.
You're all on the punks tonight.
You're in it today.
She's proud of that one, too. I can tell she's like laughing at herself. Can we get the camera on?
Oh.
Camera on Kristyn, please. You know what I wrote down for my note here? Go to Comfort. Talk about this number, please.
No. Nice segue.
Mm-hmm. That's all I'm going to say. I'm going to let you take it.
Oh, no. Okay. Okay.
I'm not putting you on the spot at all.
Oh, are you? Oh, no, no. Are you sure? You know what? I love nappy tabs. Absolutely love nappy tabs. I don't know how I just didn't feel this as a hip-hop routine either. I mean, it was so, all the moves felt so contrived. It was very, I know he's a popper, so, you know, he does robot, and so he has to kind of keep all his movements little and all this stuff. But at the same time, I think part of the song was slow. Like, she was kind of catering to the fact that she's a ballerina, and she was giving you leg and extension or whatever. Like, and I'm like, wait, hold up. I know we have to make the dancers look good and everything, but this is a hip hop routine. Stay true to the fact that it is. Like, we're not a Bollywood routine. You're gonna see it looks like Bollywood. You see a contemporary routine, looks like contemporary. See, you know, down the line. And with hip hop, to me, I just see it and I'm like, I don't know if it's Broadway or hip hop. That's just kind of what happens to me.
I love these. It's a very fair assessment, I think.
But I still not that it's a bad routine. Not that it's a bad routine.
I don't know that I've ever seen nappy hip-hop. Tabs. Yeah. I don't know that I've ever seen nappy tabs choreograph a bad routine.
Never.
They're great. Never. They're a lot of fun. Mm-hmm. For people like me who I'm not in the hip hop world, contrary to popular belief, I'm not. their type of choreography is a nice, it's like that first step into hip hop for white guys like me who wear cardigans. it's fun, playful hip hop.
Mm-hmm.
But I didn't really feel, I don't like when they just starting off, when she was in a little tutu, I'm like, yeah, she's a ballerina. Make her a hip-hop dancer. It's a hip-hop number. Don't put her in a tutu because you're just discrediting her right off the get-go.
Yeah.
You're making it look like, okay, we're going to cater to her right now. And when she's very capable of dancing hip-hop.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So don't make her the ballerina. Quit putting the kicks and turns and everything else in. That's not hip-hop.
You ain't never seen nobody in the hood back in my house doing no kick.
You ain't never seen nobody in the hood. You heard her here first.
Like, real talk. Like,
that's right, exactly.
It's not being rude. It's not being mean.
No.
It's just not hip hop.
It's the truth.
You just don't see it. So.
But what was interesting was how the judges praised her. And I was like, side eye. Like, really? I was not moved. And I'm no dancer. I say this all the time. I'm not. But I have eyes. And I was just like, wow. Like that.
And beautiful eyes.
That thing.
Might I add?
Blank, blank, blank. but it just wasn't like Nigel's comment. He said that she's better than Cyrus. Like, she was a better hip hopper than Cyrus. And I was like, maybe I was watching something different. And then I was just, I mean, the whole routine was flatlined to me. And I have to say this, I hate to say it, but I'm over Cyrus. Like, I'm tired of you shaking. Like, do
and last
else.
Week you Cyrus. Couldn't get enough of his shaking,
and I'm over it because he. What else? What
they
else
haven't
do
yet.
Have?
They haven't yet got to hit what he can do. Not yet.
We
I don't
already
know.
Lost Brandon. Just
we did.
Back up a little bit. Yeah, all right. Yeah.
Keep him there.
Not I me. Think what it was it was like high concept choreography. Then that's what it was. Yeah. It was like, we have this concept. We're gonna do this thing, and we're gonna have this box, and she's a ballerina on the box, or the you know, it's like a musical box. You know, when you have the little ballerina in your jewelry box. That's what it was like. Except we're gonna make it a little bit edgy.
Yeah. I thought it was cool in their package, their intro piece. Mm-hmm. She said something interesting about it was Cyrus, correct? The belly button?
Yeah.
His belly button looks like the on button. It's like that's a certain little cool line. That's kind of funny. That's she's like, he actually cool is a robot.
Just pretty so you guys cool know.
And he started yeah shaking.
He just pushed that button.
Right.
So that brings us to the end of the actual performances.
Yes.
Now we're coming into the solos. But before we talk about the solos and before we talk to Comfort about her experience on her multiple seasons on the show, we're going to take a short commercial break and we'll be right back.
All right.
Hey there, good buddies. My handle's Woolly Bear. I'm a truck driving man, but I'm not that old school kind of truck driving man. No, I like to listen to podcasts while I'm driving through these great United States of ours. And my favorite podcasts in the world are from AfterBuzz TV. And why? Because AfterBuzz TV is like a post-game wrap-up show for all your favorite TV shows, like Jersey Shore, Dancing with the Stars, Mad Men, and a whole truckload more. I like listening to my Gossip Girl podcast, catching up with all my fellow fans and getting all the latest news and gossip. You know, I got some strong opinions. And AfterBuzz TV lets me share those opinions with thousands of other listeners. Woo-wee, what a feeling. I used to doze off on those lonely stretches of road. And don't worry, I got the cruise control. But now I'm wide awake and listening to all the AfterBuzz TV goodness. Check them out. Give them a holler. And tell them the old Woolly Bear sent you.
Did you like that commercial?
I did.
The Woolly Bear?
The Woolly
Bear. Yeah, you're going to follow him on Twitter tonight. Woolly Bear.
Right. We went all country over here.
We did.
So we move into the announcement of the bottom six, essentially. The bottom three girls, the bottom three guys. The bottom three girls, Amber, Eliana, and...
Lindsay.
One of the blondes. Terrible. I'm a jerk.
Shocker.
And then the bottom three guys, we've got George, Brandon. Ugh. And then who was the other
Darian
one? Darian. Yeah. These bottom three has kind of shocked me. For me, let's start with the girls. Especially the girls really shocked me because I think they're all really strong mm-hmm dancers. I didn't expect to see any of them there. I felt like if any of them, maybe Lindsay's kind of a duplicate, but I feel like Lindsay's kind of come on strong the last couple of weeks. Mm-hmm. Whereas Whitney earlier in the season, Whitney was like the little firecracker that always stood out. I feel like Lindsay's been holding her own with her lately. Mm-hmm. You know, the little friends, and they're the two that are going to be compared the most. Mm-hmm. They're friends. They look the same. They're the same style. Mm-hmm. They're kind of duplicates.
Same studio, everything.
Yeah.
You know, the one thing about Lindsay, and we saw this last week, they were talking a little bit about her immaturity in her dance, you know, that she really needs to sort of step that up, step up the emotional side to it. So I actually wasn't that surprised that Lindsay was there. I think Amber, I mean, she was amazing this week, and she was very, very good last week. I mean, she totally made us forget who Nick was, but I feel like, again, she got dragged down by somebody else, and it really wasn't her fault for being in the bottom three.
And you also, it kind of makes you wonder about the demographic of the show right now. Like, who's watching this? Who's actually voting? I think if there's a bunch of, like, little white girls in middle America watching, they'd love to see the little blonde girls. They remind them of their friends and whatever. And you look at who got sent home, they were the two mature ones. They were a sister and a brother. That, you know what I mean? Maybe it's just not the demographic this season. I don't know, but it breaks my heart to see that Amber shouldn't even been in the bottom three.
No, she shouldn't have been. She really shouldn't have been.
She was
been
amazing.
Yeah.
And even her performance last week, what was it, ballroom or?
It was ballroom last week, yeah.
She killed it, in my opinion. I'm no dancer, but in my eyes, she killed it.
She got better every week.
We have an AfterBuzz exclusive, ladies and gentlemen. Corrine Williams is not a dancer.
Hello.
You guys didn't know that.
TV exclusive.
I mean, I'm a club dancer.
Right.
Back that back up. But not technically trained.
So, she's going to wear a sign around her neck. Not a dancer.
Yeah.
Natural.
She's going to have a shirt made for next week. So they had – this is what really bothers me about the show this season. They – all three of these bottom dancers don't get a chance to dance a solo to save themselves. I don't understand why, because it takes an extra minute. But they only choose. They chose Amber and Eliana to go up against each other and didn't even Lindsay. So here's my first thought was, well, Lindsay's obviously not going home. Because if they don't give her a chance to dance for her life right now and then they send her home, people would be in an uproar. And if I were Lindsay, I'd be really furious. Yeah. But then that puts a lot of pressure on Amber and Eliana because they have to be thinking the same thing.
Yeah.
And they both went out there and danced. And I thought, I actually felt like Amber danced a better solo than Eliana.
Ditto.
I didn't think Eliana was bad. I thought that Amber could have done a lot more. I thought they were both a little bit lackluster.
Kind of flat. They were both kind of flat.
To be honest, they were both kind of. But I think that when you're looking at their performances from tonight, which is what makes it tricky because that's not what we're voting on. But if you look at their performances from tonight, Amber looked like she fell more flat because Eliana kind of stepped it up from her performance in the with her partner, because her performance with the partner was kind of crap. It wasn't that great for me.
Yeah.
So her solo looked better in comparison.
Yeah.
Amber, though, in comparison to her phenomenal number she did earlier night, you can't strike gold twice in one night. It's not going to happen. Lightning only strikes once. Whatever. I feel like she just didn't live up to the prior performance.
Hmm.
And we got to see Eliana twice right at the very end of the show, whereas Amber's first performance was way at the beginning. Mm, so yeah. It's a little more fresh in the judges' mind. I don't know. I don't know how much that all factors in. I don't know if they really just had their minds made up before any of this ever happened.
And that's the problem, too. We're not hearing the feedback that they're getting from the choreographers. We're completely in the dark as to what mm-hmm. is happening. You know, what kind of feedback is Amber getting from the choreographers she's worked with in the last few weeks? Same thing with Eliana. So without giving us any insight to that, we don't know. And that's frustrating as a viewer. I mean, I wish that they would have, like, the choreographers do maybe a little confessional or something. Mm-hmm.
Maybe.
That's a good idea.
That is a good idea.
Instead of just always sitting in the group of, like, the nerdy group of choreographers in the audience being, like, so excited all the time. Yeah. They all look like, hey, we're so excited to be here promoting our choreography. Right.
That's funny.
They just look silly.
I have a question for Comfort. Do you know when, like, your name is going to be called in the bottom? Or is it just, like, a gut feeling? Like,
oh, it's a gut feeling. You kind of don't know when your name's going to get called. You kind of have, like, an idea if you're going to be at the bottom, if, you know, depending on our routines and who was actually better, who, like, you know, the judges praised that week, and, you know, more so than someone else. And then kind of by that judge actually tells you, you know, that judge is who's going to be at the bottom, to be quite honest. So...
Well, these three ladies were at the bottom and came down to Amber and Eliana. They sent Amber home, as we've already clarified for the last 50 minutes.
Since the beginning, actually, the beginning of the show.
Breaks my heart.
Too. We've been pouting all show.
Right. So we move on to the guys. And we've got, again, George, Darian?
Yes.
Darian. And Brandon.
Darian did his thing, though.
Darian did. And Darian and Brandon both went out there. And Brandon went out there. He's a stepper, so it's a little different style, you know, than these other guys. But a completely different style. And he went out there, and I thought he did a good job. Mm-hmm. I thought he had some personality. I thought by the end of his solo, he was a little boring. I thought the first 10 seconds were great. Mm-hmm. And then I was kind of like, okay, I've seen it. You're slapping your knee again. That's what it looked like
that's
to me. But I felt like his personality came from his face at the beginning of that little number.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And by the end of it, I was kind of like, he looks like he's kind of bored. He's just out there smacking things.
Well, he came out with an energy up here, and it stayed up there. He should have maybe built a little bit more and created a level. There were no levels.
Yes, because once you get to 20 seconds into it, the energy level may have already been so high, you're like, we want more now. And you can't go. There is no more. He's already given it. He's given it everything. Yeah. I thought it was okay. I thought that Darian, though.
He killed it.
Wow.
He killed it.
He's got a bag of tricks that, the kid could do no wrong. And he looked really good in those jeans. Can we just talk about
like
no?
That backside. Okay.
Yeah. Mm. But no, he's such a powerhouse.
Yes, he is.
He reminds me of Brandon short Brandon, super strong.
That was after your season.
Brandon Bryant?
Yes.
Yes.
Black Boy?
Yes.
Yeah.
On Glee and everything else now.
She can say it. I can't. Yes, that's the one. That's the
one. Black Boy? Oh, yeah.
I got it. No, she reminds me of him a little bit. He's strong and powerful and dances with a shirt off.
He's little.
He's quick. And I thought that he left it all out there. And I didn't see that coming from any of the other three soloists. I felt like all of them could have given a little bit more.
Yeah.
I felt like they didn't really pour their souls into it, and I felt like he did.
Yeah.
And I feel like he kind of earned his spot. Whether they made up their minds or not ahead of time, I feel like he earned that spot.
Yeah, he danced.
But every trick in the book he had is like, these are my tools, and throw them all in there.
As much as I love Brandon, I think he should still be on the show because I think George should have gone home because he's boring.
What? I like George.
He got to shave that
George
mustache.
George is good. Leave
that mustache
alone.
Is weird.
Get out of here. George, your
I
mustache
thought Brandon
is fine.
Did his thing too. As a stepper, it's not easy. Like to actually hold down a solo for like 30 seconds as a stepper, but they have so much energy. They're strikers all stars. That's their whole thing. Is they're like frat kids and they're just like all about energy, high energy from like the top. So yeah, maybe it could have built, but you know he learns from experience.
Right.
He learned from experience at this time.
True. And we think he's cute.
And I love him. Dimples. I love you, Dimples.
Did I also skip something completely? Yeah. I did. An Alvin Ailey number
Don't
before
talk
this.
About it.
No, Alvin Ailey was after. You're
was
after. You're in correct
I'm okay.
order.
Yeah,
okay. You're okay,
my
good
friends.
Order.
I'm good.
He's at the end.
And this is So You Think You Can Dance.
Yeah.
I thought it was pretty incredible.
Yes.
Those guys, they dance in very similar costumes what they the men danced to earlier in the season. Yeah. The high-waisted black, like long.
That is very classical for Ailey, though. I will say that.
Yes.
If you go see Alvin Ailey, and I recommend that all of you do. If you have never seen Alvin Ailey's Revelations, which is his signature piece, Ailey passed away in the 80s. However, it is one of the most moving, stunning works you will ever see in your entire life on stage.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. These guys were all so powerful, and that's what I know of Alvin Ailey dancers, and not a lot. I know they're very strong men. They're all men, and they dance like men, and they danced with men in this number too.
Yes. Oh yeah,
they were doing so, yes. I was kind of like, okay, Fox, you pushing the envelope a little bit right now.
Yep, Desmond Richardson came out of Ailey, so if you you know like his choreography and like his style of dance, like that is where his roots are. So
And you can tell.
Oh, you can tell.
Yeah, absolutely. You totally tell. Love Desmond's pieces, by the way.
Oh, me too. I love him.
We're not going to talk about Desmond's piece right now, but we're going to move on. Take a moment to talk to Comfort. Okay, we've got a couple of weeks off, you guys. P.S. So you think you can dance? The Olympics are coming up, so we're not going to be here for a couple of weeks, but we will be back in 3 weeks. Yeah.
Yeah, and the I'm going to say 15th, August 15th.
You're
August
good with numbers. 15th. I'm not. So Comfort.
What's up?
Let's just talk to you.
Hey, Mel.
What was your experience like when your very first time getting on the show? Was that the first time you actually auditioned for the show?
Yeah, that was my first time.
And you got on first time.
Yeah,
that wasn't Amber's story. Right. Where did you audition? How was your process?
It was SMU in Dallas. Mm-hmm. I was 19. Yeah, I was 19 years old. And I just kind of winged it. Me and my brothers, like my god brothers, like we just all decided just to go. We just said we have nothing to lose.
That's right.
Literally. So nothing comes to Dallas. So it was just kind of one of those moments. And I had 2.5 years of training because I went to performing arts school. But I had already graduated and I got accepted to Cal Arts, couldn't go, but I ended up just going to, you know, college and just kind of doing journalism and just didn't even do dance. Wow. I just kind of just street danced.
That's why you're such a natural in here.
Wow.
Yeah.
Who knew?
I know. She's good.
I love
it.
Good.
You're a natural.
Well, thank you. Invite me back anytime. But yeah, I just kind of just became a street dancer and street performed and became part of so many different crews. So show came around and
you made it.
And it's made it.
One hit.
And you know, you must really understand sort of what Cyrus is going through because he doesn't have a lot of training either. And you're being thrown every week into a different genre of dance. And when you don't have that foundation and all of that technique that other people have when they've had 15 years of it.
Exactly.
I mean, what you're learning a new language every week. What is it like?
It is the most frustrating thing because for me, at least, I had like 2.5 years of training or a little bit more somewhat. And it was just that much harder to try to like get thrown into something in 5.5 hours you have to learn these routines. And it's like foreign language to you completely. And with me, since I'm a hip hop dancer, I'm crazy. I talk too much. I'm country or whatever. They decided to put me in ballroom 24/7. They decided to make me a little bit more classy. They made me take my eye piercing out, my nose ring. And they made me try to, you know, change completely. So I didn't know how to do that. So I literally shut down. Like my confidence kind of just went out the window a little bit. It was hard.
You probably felt like you were losing yourself a little bit.
Yeah, a little bit. A little bit because, you know, I'm not, that's who would have thought? Like I would have even made the show, to be quite honest. I was just like winging it. I was like, oh snap. Vegas? Why?
You're adorable.
I love it.
You're really shy too, I've noticed. Yeah. What I always wonder is, and we actually, I thought of this a moment ago, when you get your choreography for the very first time, are there times you're just like, you just have a gut feeling like this is going to be terrible? Do you ever feel like, do you have any luxuries to say to the choreographers, that's not going to work?
Oh,
that's
no.
That's a good question.
No.
Oh, no.
So how do you handle that when it's your ass on the line?
You better not say nothing.
You better smile.
What do you do? Like, how do you get through that when you're like, I'm not
You have to rely on your partner. You have to rely on your partner and knowing that they know what they're doing and ask as many questions as you possibly can to the choreographer because when we do have time, we have like maybe 3 hours or so just with the choreographer and the assistants to kind of just get it together. And you go home. We go to our apartments that they have us in, and then we practice and all this other stuff. So it's if there's plenty of times I was like, oh God, this is going to go downhill fast. But I just gotta, you know, just smile through it or just push through it and rely on my partner to help me, you know, get through it and hope for the best in it, to be quite honest, because you can't say anything to the choreographers because they are very sensitive about their choreography.
Of course.
Very sensitive about it.
And as a dancer, too, you know you would never talk back to a choreographer. It's you part won't. Of the...
Well, Corrine and I are not dancers.
But
you, my dear, are a phenomenal dancer.
Thank you.
We're going to go into some predictions for next week. How about that? And I'm going to let you start. I want to hear what you think is going to go down next week because we've all been thrown for a loop with Brandon and Amber going home so
and
quickly.
Now, you're after Buzz.
Who
TV.
Do you think we need to watch this season? Who do you think is a front runner for the males and the females? And who do you think is a dark horse in the male and female category?
Oh, no. Yeah. Okay. Let's
Who's your favorite see. Guy?
My favorite guy was Dimples. Brandon. Who's my... You know what? Cole. I really like Cole. I really do. Martial arts, he's something completely different. Yeah, I just want to see what he does. They keep calling him a technician. They keep saying that he might get boring, but I think he has some tricks under his sleeve.
So who's your dark horse?
My dark horse? I don't. You know what? I don't care. I don't even know her name. Lindsay. Is it the other ballroom girl?
Whitney.
Lindsay Whitney.
No, not Whitney. Not the other one. Lindsay.
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 Yeah.
I don't know.
She can be tricky.
But I don't know. Maybe her. Is that her? Is that Cole's partner? No, that wasn't Cole's partner. Who was her partner?
Lindsay was Cole's partner.
Yeah.
That was her partner. Yep. So like that's what I was saying earlier. I was saying like I was so drawn to Cole. Like obviously I didn't even know his partner was Lindsay. sorry.
But she could go far if she's still with him.
But she can go far if she's still with him. Obviously, so obviously that's going to carry her through. But other than that, I think all the girls are amazing. To be quite honest.
What about you, Kristyn? What do you think?
You know, I've been really watching. Amelia's going to be, you know, probably my top one to watch because she's so quirky and weird and different and unique. So out of the girls, she's kind of my one to watch. The guys, I'm gonna look at Will too. I do like Cole, and I think Will is another one. I think that little grouping, that pairing is gonna carry them far.
Yes, and Corrine.
Only Cole. That's all I got.
You know, I'm gonna go with Cole too because I think that he's one of those dancers that America can really latch onto if he starts to open up a little bit because they love to see somebody show some emotion that doesn't like if you can get past those first few weeks and start to open up, people will latch onto you so quickly because he already has the technical ability.
Yeah,
and then I also think I really like Amelia. I really do. I think she's great. I don't know about her yet though. I'm not really sure. For the girls, there really isn't a standout for me just yet. It was Amber after tonight, and she's gone. So what do I know?
Yeah.
What do we all Lord. Know? And we have a bit of news and gossip. I believe you have something for me, Kristyn.
AfterBuzz TV News.
Emmy nominations were last Thursday, so it was after our show on Wednesday night. But 6 nominations for So You Think You Can Dance. And I think the big thing, I mean, the show was nominated, which is great. But Kat Dealy was finally nominated for a host. One of the best hosts in the business. I'm going to say this
easily,
over and over again.
Easily.
And I hope she wins because, you know, we've had Jeff Probst win over and over for Survivor, and he's fantastic. And no one does what Jeff Probst does. He's fantastic. But it is Kat Dealy's year.
But Jeff Probst doesn't host live very often.
No,
one show per season.
That's
Kat
right.
Kat Dealy, in my mind, is besides Maria Menounos, buy your book on Amazon. I think Kat Dealy is the best female host out there right now. And she is so great live. I absolutely adore her.
She's great.
And she looked pretty tonight, too.
Mm-hmm. She did. That She's Veronica beautiful. Lake hair. Stacey Tukey, Christopher Scott, and Spencer Liff were the three choreographers nominated for.
They changed it up a little bit this
changed
year.
Changed it
I like
up
that.
A little bit. And the other ones came from Dancing with the Stars. So, but those three are from So You Think You Can Dance. And they got a lighting design nomination, as I said. So
obviously, we love their lighting. We love the lighting in here. We all look so cute, right?
We do.
Nice. You look real good, Comfort. You look good. Everyone. Thank you. Thank you again for stopping by. We really appreciate
you
your time.
Thank
Thanks
for
bringing your mom. We love your mom.
Yay, Mama.
You guys, we want to thank you guys for stopping by. Again, we're not going to be here the next couple of weeks, but make sure you tune in to the Olympics. Enjoy it. We'll be back in mid-August. But you can follow me on Twitter at @_AJGibson.
Follow me at Comfort For Real.
At Kristyn Burtt, and that's Kristyn with the Y at the end.
Just saying, no J.
Thanks for stopping by, you guys. Take care.
Deuces.
From Bing.com, executive producers Maria Menounos, Kevin Undergaro, Phil Svitek, and the entire AfterBuzz TV staff, we would like to thank you for listening to the AfterBuzz TV Network. To watch or listen to other After shows and post comments or questions, be sure to visit AfterBuzzTV.com. I'm Sir Richard Wentworth, and this has been a presentation of AfterBuzz TV.
Buzz you later.
The views expressed herein are those of the hosts only and do not necessarily reflect the views of AfterBuzz TV or its owners or principal.